This is the Civilization 4 Analal. Hello, I am Jutlaik, you are welcome, this is the Analal. It is the third round of fixtures and the first time we see a first division game in the third round. Today we have Saladin versus Sara Jakob. They have a few things in common. Both of them were winning the round 1 games, both of them lost the round 2 games. They have also both played against Catherine. However, while Saladin won domination against the Russian Empress, Sara Jakob lost domination against her. So, this is the third round, both of them on 2 points, Saladin number 8, Sara Jakob number 11 in the league. Let's go take a look at the starting positions. Here we are with Saladin. He starts over at the east. There is a cow, there are some gems and some sugar close to his place. To the west on the continent, we have Sara Jakob's starting position, and he has 3 marbles, clam, cow, and also some iron. It is the biggest continent we start on. Probably not going to get over here to the middle of the map and to the west until astronomy. Let's see what happens, shall we, when we start the game up. Here we are, Saladin versus Sara Jakob in the third round in the first division. We have 2 different religions, Hinduism for Sara, Buddhism for Saladin. Turn 50, before turn 50, Saladin with his second city. Sara Jakob is also having 2, Saladin's first to 3, and they have closed borders with each other now. Saladin went straight west. It's going to be interesting to see who can be the fastest. It looks like Saladin has 5 cities to 4. We are at 1 AD with 7 to 4 for Saladin in the city count. Sara Jakob is coming up to 6, Saladin with 8. Sara is cautious, and Saladin is a little bit stronger than Sara Jakob at the moment. 1.1, 1.2, something like that. We are at turn 150 there. 8 cities each at the moment. It looks like it's an open game. Sara Jakob is now pleased with Saladin. Let's see what happens. Saladin is first. Sara Jakob is 9 cities, I mean. Saladin on 8. Both of them getting metal casting. Turn 175 is here. Aesthetics. Construction is next for Saladin. And their scores, they are approximately the same in score. They go up and down, but there we have the war. There we have the first declaration of war. Sara Jakob in 9 cities, Saladin on 8. A pre-turn 200 war. In other words, now Saladin is down to 7 cities. Sara Jakob has taken 1. He is up to 10 cities. Saladin down on 7. 10 to 7. And we have the peace treaty, and Saladin is up to 8 cities again, Sara Jakob 9 and Saladin 8, but that war meant that Sara Jakob now is angry with Saladin. They are approximately equal in strength. Saladin has 1.0, the strength of Sara Jakob, which is exactly the same. Going for engineering now, getting that one, and we have the next war just as he gets engineering. Philosophy next for both of them, 9 cities to Saladin, Sara Jakob's down to 8. Saladin is in Buddhism still, Sara Jakob is going for feudalism now, while guilds comes to Arabia. We have a peace treaty signed, Saladin is going to get guilds, Sara Jakob's going to get feudalism, he gets that now. 9 cities Sara Jakob, 8 cities Saladin, we are at turn 230, which is 1600 AD. Saladin is a little bit stronger than Sara Jakob now, 1.2 times the strength, he's going to get banking. While Sara Jakob is on the civil service path, Saladin going for paper, Sara getting the alphabet and going straight for paper, Saladin on compass, 9 cities each now. This game is very close. 9 cities each, and Saladin is going for education. Sara Jakob has completed the Mausoleum of Mausolus, I just saw that. And Sara Jakob is going for nationalism, Saladin is on economics. 9 cities each, but they don't seem to be that eager to go back into war. Maybe they have a plan for what they want to do. Saladin is also trying to go for nationalism now, so both of them are on nationalism. Saryakub's going to get it a few turns before Saladin. 9 cities each. And Sarah is on compass as well. And let's see, liberalism next for Saladin. Sarah is on education, but Saladin's going to get liberalism first. It's turn 270 now, and he's getting it. I don't know what he took, but he's on constitution at the moment. Saryakub is on education, 9 cities each. And corporation is coming. Saryakub is on guilds and Saladin on optics and going for astronomy. So Saladin is going to expand into the new world pretty soon. He's getting astronomy right now. Saryakub is going for the constitution and Saladin with gunpowder. Chemistry next. We have spies on the scene, by the way. Saryakub is down to cautious with Saladin now, and Saladin going for the military science. Sarah, and there it is, the circumnavigation, and that also means that Saladin is capable of getting his settlers out, isn't he? Let's see if he can do that. 9 cities each, and there is the first city in the new world in the middle of the map. It's a Saladin city. If you start 10 cities now for the Arabian leader, Saryakub still on 9, going for communism next, Saladin. And Saryakub is on chemistry, 10 cities to 9. Is he going to start spreading his empire in the new world now, Saladin, to get an advantage that he can use? Is down to 0.9, the strength of Saryakub, though. Saryakub is going for the democracy, and Saladin. Saladin is going culture! Saladin is going culture! He has 90 or 100% of the cultural slider. That could be a good thing, or it could be a mistake. It's turn 3-3-2 now. Saladin is going culture. What are you going to do with that, Saryakub? He's getting astronomy right now, the Ethiopian leader as well. And Saryakub with 10 cities, Saladin with 9. Going for the scientific method, but Saladin is weaker than Saryakub. Saladin is down to 0.8 the strength. He's building another city in the new world. Both of them going for communism. Saryakub is the only one that is getting it. Saladin going for culture, turn 352. And he's also building a few new cities, but Saryakub has also started building new cities in the continent down in the middle. South and the middle. 13 Ethiopian cities, 14 Ethiopian cities, Saladin's up to 12 as well. But Saladin is now trying to go for culture, but is Saryakub also going culture? Because he is not teching either. Saryakub has over 60 turns left to the physics thing. So I think that both of them may be trying to go for a cultural victory right now, but Saladin started that a lot. Oh, Saryakub is teching again. And he's going for rifling, 14 cities each. But now it doesn't look like Saryakub is teching. It looks like he's going culture. Both of them are trying to go for a cultural victory. And there is a legendary city there, Beberhan. So turn 395, I think that Saladin is going to get it unless Saryakub attacks him and takes one of the three Arabian cities. Saladin is 6 turns away from steel, but he's still going towards culture. And there it is, turn 405, 1985, Saladin has won a cultural victory. Saryakub never found a way to deny him that. It was a very well-performed cultural victory. He came far enough into the tech tree that he was safe, and then he went for it. Let's go take a look at the replay, shall we? congratulations to Saladin then for the cultural victory. There were two wars declared in this game. Saladin declared both of them. First in 1250 AD, turn 185. That one he actually lost. He lost one city. He captured none himself. In turn 213 in AD 1515 AD, he declared the second war. That was a stalemate after both leaders capturing one city each. I guess after that he just gave up on the war thing and went culture instead, which he successfully won at turn 1995, turn 405. So let's look at the statistics then. Let's go exit. This is the score. They were pretty even in score all game long. GNP was pretty even. Manufacturing, that was actually Sarayakop a little bit ahead towards the end there. Food, that was Saladin a little bit ahead. Power, it was Sarayakop towards the end, but that is because Saladin went for culture and stopped doing the military thing, I guess. Culture, we see it is pretty even here, Saladin winning it, but Sarayakop not that far behind. It's going to be interesting to see that one. Espionage, Sarayakop was number one. Let's take a look at the demographics here then. Saladin with 3,483 GNP and Sarayakop 4,028. So Sarayakop had more, which means that he probably was catching up towards the cultural victory. Soldiers, land area, population, almost 27 million for Saladin, 16.5 million for Sarayakop. They have a high approval rate thanks to all the cultural stuff happening. The wonders, let's go to the bottom first and take a look at the bottom cities. 1, 2, 3 wonders in the BC era, Stonehenge, Kashiwishvanath, and the Oracle. And we see Sarayakop is number one and number two city. Saladin has the third and fourth and fifth. And then Sarayakop has city number six as well. Let's go to the statistics then. This is the Saladin 15 cities built. Three religions, one golden age. Let's go and take a look. 46 current towns, 21 minimums, 13 farms in your cities. You did build 11 barracks, 10 granaries, and 10 Hindu temples. Four Confucian academies down there, page down. Sistine Chapel, which helped a little bit, I think. Globe Theater is here as well. Statue of Zeus, Statue of Liberty. Let's go to page down. And the Hanging Gardens is here. Go to the top and let's see your current units. 26 riflemen, 17 grenadiers, 15 workers, all the way down to a caravel. What did you build? You built a total of 25 archers, 24 axemen, 20 Taoist missionaries, down to 2 great artists, page down. And a grenadier at the bottom. You killed 14 chariots, 11 swordsmen, 7 axemen, down to a trebuchet. You lost 8 axemen, 4 catapults, 4 longbowmen, 4 chariots, 3 war elephants and 2 spearmen. Okay, Saladin. Let's go to Sarayakop. 14 cities built, 4 religions, 1 golden age. Currently you have 49 windmills, 19 towns and 7 fishing boats and 7 mines. You built in your cities 13 granaries, then 10 out of a whole lot of stuff. 6 Taoist monasteries at the bottom there, page down. And you see Taj Mahal. The Oracle is here, Parthenon, Spalminum Ret, Notre Dame, page down. He did build an academy, and University of Sankor is here. Mausoleum of Masolos, that's a good one. Apostolic Palace is here. He built Oxford University. Colossus is here. Pyramids, Stonehenge, Great Library, and Great Lighthouse. Top. Currently, you have these units, 41 grenadiers, 16 Oromo warriors, and 15 longbowmen, all the way down to a caravel. You built 38 Islamic missionaries, 24 Hindu missionaries, 23 archers, 5 great artists. all the way down to one great spy. Let's confirm the kills, 8 X-Men, and you see down to 2 Spearmen, and your losses, 14 Chariots, 11 Swordsmen, and blah blah blah, down to 1 Trebuchet. So that was Sara Jakob. Now, let's go and take a look at the victory condition screen and the cities. First, let's take a look at the victory condition screen then. How close! Medina just got legendary, and look, 3 turns left until Lalibela could have become legendary as well, so Sara Jakob was really close to this victory. He didn't get it. It was Saladin, because Saladin started, but Ethiopia Sara Jakob, he had more GNP per turn towards the end, so he was catching up. He just was less than 2,000 points behind in Lalibela. Oh, that was close. Nobody was close to domination, nobody was close to conquest either then, and yeah, space, no Apollo program, and built the Apostolic Palace, but nothing. So, let's go take a look at the cities. Exit, and this is Saladin, so let's go and take a look at Saladin cities. Let's sort by population. Building wealth in Damascus, and then some units and some buildings, as we can see. Okay, let's go and find Sara Jakob's cities. Let's go Sara Jakob. Okay, let's click here and let's sort by population. Building the Kremlin in Addis Abeba. Wait a minute. Sara Jakob. Kremlin in Addis Ababa, as I said. Debreberan, Adulis, and Matara with Pop 17, Axum 15, and Lalibela Addis Ababa, and Kuwaito 14. Some Oromo warriors, and some buildings. Spoiler alert, results and updated league tables follows after this screen. The league table is updated, and we see that Saladin now is up to 5th place with his 4 points. He has plus minus 0 in score per turn difference. Sara Jakob 11th with his 2 points and negative 17 score per turn difference. Next up is the game between Cyrus and Qinqi Wang in just a few minutes, but until then, have a good day. Oh,